Hello everyone, welcome to Loving Maestro. I am your host Vedant Javla, and today we are going to learn a new lesson of science, that is force and pressure, grade 8. So without wasting any of our time, let's start with our today's session. Force. Force is a push or a pull that causes a change in speed, direction or shape. The SI unit of force is Newton, and Newton is denoted as capital N. Here is an image where you can see that a person is pushing a block where the other one is pulling the block. Effects of force. Force can produce the following effects. First, a force can move a stationary object. Second, a force can stop a moving object. Third, force can change the speed of a moving object. Fourth, a force can change the direction of a moving object. Fifth, that is, a force can change the shape and size of an object. Force acting in the same direction. When two forces act on an object in the same direction, the forces add up to produce a large force. The magnitude of two forces in the same direction is added to get the resultant force. For example, if F1 and F2 are forces acting on an object, the resultant force will be F is equal to F1 plus F2. Forces acting in the opposite direction. If two forces are acting in the opposite directions on an object, the net force acting on it is difference between the two forces. For example, if F1 and F2 are the forces acting on an object, the resultant force F equal to F1 minus F2. Balanced force. Balanced force are those forces acting in opposite directions on an object, and they are equal in size. Examples of balanced force: a game of tug of war is equally matched teams on either side is an example of balanced force. In this, the rope does not move as equal and opposite force is applied from each side. Types of forces. Types of forces are categorized as contact forces and non-contact forces. Contact forces are further bifurcated into muscular force and frictional force, as the non-contact forces are further bifurcated into magnetic force, gravitational force, and electrostatic force. Contact forces. Contact forces are the forces that act between two objects that are physically touching each other. First, muscular force. The force applied by the action of muscles in a body is termed as muscular force. For example, when you pick up a book placed on the table using your hands, you apply muscular force. Second, frictional force. Friction is the force that resists motion when the surface of one object comes in contact with the surface of another. If it is also friction in the tires that allows the car to stay on the road, and friction in the clutch that makes it possible to drive. If there is no friction, we would not be able to walk, we will simply slip off. But due to friction, we are able to walk. Here are some examples of muscular force given in the diagram. Here you can see that a football is rolling on the ground and the football is going towards the right, but the frictional force is acting opposite to the ball's direction. Non-contact force. A non-contact force is a force which acts on an object without coming physically in contact with it. For example, gravitational force. A gravitational force is a force that attracts any two objects with mass. Magnetic force. Magnetic force is a force that attracts certain metal objects like iron towards a magnet. Electrostatic force. which is very interesting. Electrostatic force can be stated as the force between two electrically charged particles. They can either be repulsive or attractive force. Like charges will repel each other and unlike charges will attract each other. I want to give you an example of electrostatic force. You can simply take a balloon, you can fill it with air, then you can rub it with a piece of synthetic cloth, and then you can stick it on the wall and just leave it and it will stick without any gum. And that is because the balloon gets charged and it can stick to the wall. And non-charged body is attracted by a charged body. Gravitational force example. Ball is thrown in the air, comes back to the force due to the Earth's gravity. Magnetic force. Here you can see that the south and the north are attracting each other, where the north knot is repelling each other. So If they are opposite, then they will attract, and if they are the same poles, then they will repel. Electrostatic force. Like charges repel, whereas opposite charges attract. Pressure. The force acting on a unit of a surface is called pressure. Pressure is equal to force divided by area. Pressure exerted by liquids. As the depth of the water increases, the pressure of water gradually increases. The greater the depth of a point in a liquid, the greater is the pressure. Liquids also exert pressure on the walls of the vessel in which they are stored. The sideways pressure exerted by liquids also increases with the depth of the liquid. Pressure exerted by gases. Gases also exert pressure on the walls of the container. All the gases are made up of tiny molecules which move around quickly in all directions. The fast moving molecules collide with one another and the walls of the container. Example, inflating a balloon, filling air in bicycle tire. Atmosphere pressure. There is an air all around us. This envelope of air is known as the atmosphere. The pressure exerted by the air is known as atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure. Pressure exerted by air on the surroundings reduces with altitude. Low in warm areas, high in cold areas, measured using a barometer or a manometer. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe my channel, share it with your family and friends. I hope you liked my video, and if you have any suggestion, do write it in the comments. I will meet in the next video. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.